Today I'm doing a what's on my iPhone video. So I just have my black iPhone 5 and my case is this VS pink case, and yeah, I'm putting my phone on top of this bandage box. But so my home screen is just from Disneyland. It's currently this time and date. Okay, so this is my home screen, and on here I just have the basic areas. I have my utilities right here, and in here I just have these basic apps that come with the phone, and Twitter, Facebook, Kick. These are all the apps that I use a lot. School Loop to check my grades for school and stuff like that. Instagram, music. Here is my photo stuff that I use to edit, so I'll get into that in a bit. Quizlet, some social media up here, pretty straightforward basic stuff. Line and Viber are for basically international purposes, but the rest is all social media related. Nothing much. You guys can check out my Tumblr, Ask and Vine. I will have that linked down below. I don't make any vines, but I revine a lot of vines. And over here I have a whole lot of games. Don't really play them that much, but they're just kind of there. Some more entertainment stuff. Pretty basic, you guys can see it for yourselves. I don't really have to describe it for you. USPeakly is basically just some like gossip. Over here is just all my shopping kind of related stuff. Retail Me Not is a really good app to get like discounts and stuff if you want to go shopping and you want to pay full price. My friend paid full price for, so check out all that stuff. I have my Poshmark, that will be linked down below as well. And I just have the news. Over here is reference. I use this for like school and stuff. I have like all these like, you know, basic stuff. Spark Notes, Study Blue. My Wells Fargo to check my bank account. Yelp, Slater. Over here I have some more other stuff. iBooks, find my iPhone, pay by phone for like when you got to the city, you can just pay by your phone instead of going to the meter. Rent the Runway is a new app that I found. It's to just rent some dresses, and I think that's just a pretty cool app to look at sometimes because some of those dresses are really pretty. But yeah, that's basically my iPhone. Nothing really much to it. Sorry, this video I kind of went kind of fast. My camera's running out of memory. But yeah, that's pretty good. Make sure to check out all the links down below, and I hope you guys give this video a thumbs up because you like my basic iPhone. I'm filming on this, you know, picture frame with me and my friend. My case is from Pink. And yeah, that's pretty much it. My lock screen is basically, it's basically just a picture of Paradise Pier in Disneyland. Really pretty. I love Disneyland. I haven't been there in so long since I last went. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed, and I edit all my photos. So I'm gonna start off with Afterlight. Camera Plus is what I use to do like for timer photos, but nothing much besides that. So let's go on to Afterlight. And over here I already have it open to the camera roll. I'm just gonna use this picture of me and my friend. So we're just gonna edit that picture. And how I like to edit it is first I like to fix the lighting usually. I'm gonna make this a little bit brighter. I'm gonna go, if I need to, I'll clarify it to make it look a little bit better. But I think it looks pretty good already. Sometimes I'll go into fading, sometimes I'll do other stuff to it, but today I'm just gonna go straight into the filters. I'm just gonna use Guest. I use Rust a lot for this kind of like rustic kind of look, I guess. I don't really know, but I like to use that one. I like to go for more natural tones, and sometimes I'll use Grove in the Seasons kind of picture part, and it makes it really green, but it has this nice like kind of theme. So I'll put it to like this tone right here, so I think it looks perfect that way. And yeah, that's pretty much how I edit my photos. Usually I'll put a little bit of a border. I'll crop it sometimes, but I'll put a border and I just go like that, and I post them on Instagram. But yeah, so that's how I would edit that photo. Sometimes I'll do a little bit more of a fade to make it look a little bit more faded, but you know, usually I just kind of leave it like that. So that's how I edit in Afterlight. Nothing really much to it, but yeah, that's Afterlight. And PicFrame is basically all these different collages that I'd make. It's pretty handy. I like this one because I can adjust the what I'm collaging in it. So let's take two of these pictures from a shoot that I did with my friend, and I can take out the white part and just kind of put it like this, which I really really like, because some things I can't, some apps I can't do that. So I can, and they give you a whole bunch of different frames. I can go like this, so it looks like I'm kind of jumping on top of each other. I don't know, but I really like this app. It's super handy. It's a paid app, but it's honestly worth it. And Whiteagram, I use this for to put the white border around my photos when Afterlight doesn't let me do that to my other photos to post on Instagram. And I'll use Studio very little. I never get the time to go on this app. I found this on some girls like kind of Instagram. It's really artsy and it's really cool. I never really got a chance to play around with this, but if you ever get a chance, make sure to try this app out. It's like another Instagram. It's called Studio. Really cool app. Next I use VSCO Cam, and this is my second most used app. I'll come here and I'll edit like a lot of my photos, as you can see. This is where all the magic happens usually. So I'll just start off with using this one picture, right? Let's see. I'm gonna use one of these old pictures right here. And it'll import into here, and you could choose as many photos as you'd like. So I'm just gonna start with this edit. So first I wanna come here and I wanna make this image a little bit brighter, not too bright. So I'll put it like that. Sometimes I'll mess with the temperature to make it a little bit warmer, a little bit colder, but I'm not gonna do that right now. There's contrast as well. That one looks a lot better. And yeah, sometimes I'll use a little bit more fade, but today it's not really necessary. I don't really use that as much. And my two most used filters on this is M5 and T1. And also, let's see here. And maybe C1, but mostly M5 and T1. Mainly I use those two apps because they usually work. M5, I kind of have to be careful with that one because it makes it really orange, but for some of the natural tone photos, it comes out really well. So in this, I'm just going to use T1. So I'm just going to make it go down a little bit, a notch, put yes, go back here, and I'll fade it out a little bit more because I want it a little more faded. Actually, no, I don't want to fade it. I take that back. I want it to be more saturated. So I'll come over to here. Or I can use temperature. I'll make it a little bit warmer, but not as warm as M5, I believe. So yeah, that's basically how I edit my photos. And I'll go hit save to camera roll right here, and I'll save. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how I edit all my photos. Mozio Cam is where you can take multiple photos at once. As you can see, you really can. It's a ton of different frames, but I don't really use this app a lot. It's just kind of there. I got it for free. Photoshop is where you could just basically Photoshop yourself. There's my husband, Dylan O'Brien. I will show you one of the photos that I... So this is basically one of them. Oops, what did I do? Unerase. Or undo. There you go. And what I'm going to do is kind of just show you right here. It's kind of mean. Him and it's like, oh my gosh, we're so fabulous. But yeah, that's my husband. I really love him a lot. Yeah, but that's pretty much what this app is for, to Photoshop yourself. And I think I did a pretty good job in this one. You know, we both look super good. But yeah, and that's basically how I edit all my photos over here. This is just basically to put like a white border around my videos. So nothing really interesting. Let's do this one from Summer Splash. I can select the video. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I can hit save. I'll process and I'll save onto my phone after that, and I can import this to Instagram and have a little white border around it so it doesn't look so crappy. So let me show you that right now. As you can see right here, it's a white border, so it looks pretty good. And that was the wanted, super fabulous. And yeah, so that's square ready. And I have Flickagram, which is basically what you guys know. It's a video, all these different types of photos, and it could go as fast or slow as you want, and you could customize your song in it. So that app is pretty cool as well. And Download Light is just to convert videos to different things. I only ever use that app once, never really use it again, but if necessary, I will. I don't really know what it's for right now, but I believe it's a video that you can take from like Facebook or something, and you can convert it to something, to a video.